Yes, Balista.
On behalf of Chennai chapter, I welcome you all for today's wonderful session to be led by Mohan sir. And I request our member Jayadas ma'am to please welcome and introduce the speaker for today. Over to Jayadas ma'am.
Thank you, Felista. Good afternoon to all our dignity members. Now today, I'm so happy to introduce Mr. Mohan Krishnan, our speaker for today's topic, Crisis Management Lessons from Ramayana. Mr. Mohan Krishnan is a retired GM from Reserve Bank. He is also a happiness coach, storyteller, and a wellness curator. At the age of 29, Mohan ji studied Vedanta, and it transformed him to a gentler human being. He uses stories from Ramayana, Mahabharata, Kabir Das couplets in his training sessions. He loves to sing, he loves to act, and he loves to write as well. Now, today's topic, crisis management lessons. Now, how can we cope with critical situations? We should know how to de-stress ourselves, and we should know how to handle the challenging situations with peace. Now, let us all listen to Mohanji's presentation on crisis management lessons from Ramayana. Over to you, Mr. Mohan Krishnan.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm not using any mic or something. Am I audible clearly?
Yes, audible.
I'm not using any mic. And what I would suggest is, in between, if anyone wants to answer a question, I would reserve the last 10 minutes for any kind of questions. But in case there is something, you can always raise your hand in that reaction. So, Jai Shri Ram, Jai Hanuman. The time, according to Vedic culture, is divided into yugas. We have the first yuga called the Satya Yuga. The second yuga is called the Treta Yuga. The third yuga is called Dwapara Yuga. And we are now in Kali Yuga, first quarter. So how do you know we are in the first quarter? So people who do sankalpa, you know, they'll be saying, Kali Yuga Pratame Pade. That means you are in the first quarter. Now, according to the Vedic culture, what is the goal of the Vedic culture? Is it meant only for India? In India, is it meant only for one religious denomination? What is the purpose and how is it constructed? I'm not going elaborately into the subject. I'm going to take only one small section of that. The Vedic culture is for human beings in general. It is for Manushya. It is for the Purusha. Purusha means man, woman, both included. It is for universal values. And the values are given in the form of certain texts. In the text, they talk about values in very plain terms. And then and these are said to have come not from one brain, but from a number of people. It is not one man's creation. It is a number of wise people's creation. Those wise people are called by the term Rishi. Rishi means one who has insight. One who has a vision. Like for instance, Isaac Newton is a Rishi. Sir Albert Einstein is a Rishi. Thomas Alva Edison is a Rishi. Going by the same standard, your, what's his name, the Windows man, Bill Gates is a Rishi. Steve Jobs are Rishis. They have vision on how to make things work. So there are a lot of Rishis who have created so much. And there are texts available. And the Rishis have also felt, and the Rishis and the subsequent other wise people who have come after them have felt that if we can make the whole thing available in the form of stories, the form of episodes, and give the people the freedom to interpret it according to the times, if the universal values can be interpreted according to times, it will be of help for humans for all time to come. That is the purpose. Ramayana and Mahabharata, I'm going to dwell on Ramayana today, maybe some other time we'll go into Mahabharata. Ramayana and Mahabharata are referred to as Itihasa. Itihasa means it so happened, it's history. They are also referred to as Amarakavya. Amarakavya means immortal poems. Therefore, a historic incident told in poetic language. For example, there was a person called Rama. History. Now the poet comes. He was tall, handsome. His hands reached up to his knees. And when he walked, it looked like it was jingle bells all the way. And the poet composed. He said, Thumak chalat Ramachandra. Thumak chalat Ramachandra. So history, poetry. History, poetry. Therefore, itihasa, amarakavya. The purpose is not to determine whether Ramayana happened or not. It doesn't matter. What matters is, what can we learn from Ramayana, which we can apply to our life today? Not today, now. Between 4 and 5 and after. Oh yeah, good, good, I will apply it in my 80th year. Then I ask my well, not apply. This is valid only for 20-year-olds. I may as well not apply. It should be valid for me now. Otherwise, it's not worth investing time and heart in the subject. That's how I've picked up some episodes. I picked up some nice stories, which I'll be sharing with you today. Okay, so let's start. The kingdom is called Kosala. And the capital of Kosala is Ayodhya. There's a king named there, Dasharatha. He had 3 wives. Sumitra, youngest. Kaikeyi, second and the most beautiful. First one, Kaushalya. According to the practices of the royals, they always had more than one consort. Quite simply for political reasons. So if you marry the princesses around your kingdom, you know, so much of buffer state is created. So if you go to Mahabharata, they'll say Pandu married a person, you know, Kunti, and the other person, Madri. Madri came from Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh is Egypt. Afghanistan, beyond Afghanistan border. So if you had a queen from there, you know, you're protected buffer state. So the royals married more than once for the sake of political convenience. In that Treta Yuga, when people married for political convenience, we had an icon, Sri Ram. The name Purushottam Ram applies only for Ram. You can't put it for anybody else. Because he is a Purusha Uttama. An icon for a Purusha. How should a man be? That's the beauty of Rama. And Ram stands for 3 things. I'm sure there are some dance artists here. Dance artists who know Bharatanatyam, other such dances. You would always show Ram like this. Ram always stands straight. Right hand like this stands for Dharma. Meaning appropriate action all the time. Mindfulness all the time. He looks straight ahead. No point of time you will ever find Rama reclining. Rama stands straight, looks straight ahead. Clarity of vision. He stands for clarity of vision. Stand straight, depth of foundation. Depth of foundation on moral values and integrity. And holds a bow in his hand. Uncompromising pursuit of truth. lessons for you and me. If these are the values, even if we can follow relatively, see, we are senior citizens, dignitarians. What do we need in this age? 60 plus, what do we need? I need dignity. I don't demand respect. I don't demand respect. I command respect by my dignity. I conduct myself so well, so properly, that respect comes to me. I don't have to go looking for respect. The depth of my moral foundation, my integrity is so strong that my children and grandchildren are afraid to do wrong. I remember as a 17-year-old boy, okay, we all used to sit. We were all born and brought up in Kolkata. We used to sit at street corners. We had something called Adda there. All of us would sit together and chat. Then my father used to come from that side and he would call one of us. And in this gang of about 17, 18, 15 were smokers. All 15 will hide the cigarette or throw it away. Why? A certain moral depth of this person, it is called Tejas, creates a certain, they call it, you know, abashedness. In Sanskrit, it is called Hri. Hri means abashedness. I am afraid to do wrong in the presence of such a person. Just imagine dignitarians with this kind of value in every family. Hey, there is a question of corruption. There is a question of broken families. There is a question of rift in the family. There is a question of dysfunctional homes. Ram, as a character, we should have the picture straight up in front. And stern lies, clarity of vision, depth of foundation in values and integrity, uncompromising pursuit of truth. That's wrong. Then, when it comes to interaction with people, when it comes to communication, when it comes to communication in particular, that precise and concise communication. Precise and concise communication comes to you from clarity of thinking. There is no loose thinking here. If thinking is loose, communication will be a problem. So, Dasharatha. Dasharatha stands for good man, successful king, very successful king, but some one or two screws loose here. Sorry to use that expression. He tells his beautiful queen, you are so beautiful, you saved my life. You can ask for 3 boons anytime you want. She chose the correct time and he was finished. Loose thinking, poor communication. What was Ram's communication? Kaikeyi comes and tells him, your father has told me that you will not be crowned king tomorrow. You will not be crowned prince tomorrow. You will go to the fire. You will go on exile. Ram goes and says, Mata, I've always called you Mata. Why do you have to use father's name to give me these instructions? Don't you have confidence in yourself? I will obey you. Tell me what to do. Okay. A person who values his words. In Tamil, they say, he says, I will carry it up. And he goes immediately, not tomorrow, not next week, no travel, transit time, no time to pack the bags. He said, I am an exile. Discard the royal clothes, wear ordinary clothes, and leave. And look at the example Rama sets when he is ready to leave. His wife Sita says, I will accompany my husband. Just imagine Sita married him, let's say 15 days ago, from a kingdom called Mithila. The queen of, she's the princess of Mithila, daughter of Janaka, royal, luxurious life. She did not say, "Main papa ke mummy ke chali jaungi." She never said that. She said, "I'll go with my husband. I promise to stay with him. I'll stay." She'll be concentrating on their security. I can't take for you, take after you. I can't look after you. This wife makes another commitment. She says, "Okay, I will live the same way that my husband lives. If the husband lives in forest, in the palace, I will live like as though I am in exile. I will live in a hut. And if he doesn't sleep for 14 years, I don't sleep for 14 years. Okay, and I just come and connect all this with one beautiful value which all of them can have. Then comes the third brother, Bharata. When he hears, he tells his mother, "Hey, what kind of a person are you? You sent Ram on exile. You have not understood your son well. You have assumed that your son is a selfish, greedy guy." And he runs after Ram. And Ram says, "Word given is given. I have told my mother, I have told my father that I will be on exile. Bharat says, "How can I rule?" He says, "Yes, you can rule by proxy." He says, "Give me your paduka." And he takes that. Now let's commit, connect all these three. Commitment. Commitment to a spoken word. Commitment to each other's welfare and overall welfare of the kingdom. If there was a dispute, brother, between the brothers, if the older brother said, "Nothing doing, I'm going to fight for my right," people are affected. For the sake of people, Ram says, "No, this is how I stand for. Tomorrow people will quote me as a Purushottama, so I'll stand for this." The younger brother says, "I'll stand for the same value." The next younger brother says, "I'll stand for the same value." Their wives stand for the same value. Let's take this as an absolute thing. Somebody once said, "Is it possible to follow all this?" My simple counter was like this. When ships sail, okay? When ships sail, they all look at the pole star for guidance. You can't reach the pole star, never in your lifetime. But it is always there showing you that this is the path. So if the adarsha set by Rama and his brothers is the adarsha for us, holding on to that GPS, we can navigate our path beautifully. That's a GPS to which I can hook. It'll say, "After two roads, turn right." Okay, we trust a voice. Some strange voice up there. We don't even know who the face is. Can't we trust a GPS called Ram? Who by conduct? There are three things very, very important in conduct. There is something called, first step is called, it is called vichara. Thought. What is your thought? The next is achara, conduct. The third is prachara. If vichara, achara, and prachara are in one alignment, you are Rama. As senior people, as people with our young family members looking up to us, our children, grandchildren looking up to us, suppose we are able to stand for V, A, and P. Imagine what kind of support system, what a lovely support system can we give. Some people say, "I'm not able to hear properly. My connection shows properly. It's about sound. I'll do something. I'll connect it to my and put my earphones on. Just give me 2 minutes." I'll put my headphones so that you can. Yeah, sorry for the interruption, Jai Shri Ram. So, if as senior citizens, we stand for proper vichara, proper achara, proper prachara. Vichara is here, achara is in my hand, prachara is in my mouth. Can we align ourselves? What kind of, you know, with India's population, where we form, the senior citizens form about 10 to 12% of India's population. And by 2020, we are going to form 30% of the population. That is about 40, 50 crores. If this is going to be the bank of wisdom, you understand the glory of the nation. Whereas if this top brain is going to be weak, loose thinking, then we are going to have problems. So Rama stands for these qualities, beautiful qualities. Then he comes down, he moves, he comes down to further down, then comes to Kishkindha. In Kishkindha, before coming to Kishkindha, Sita is abducted. We'll go into that abduction a little later. I'm going to come to Kishkindha. You have come to Kishkindha. There is a crisis on hand. I am looking for somebody. Ram is the prince of Ayodhya. His brother is the ruling prince there. His son-in-law of the king of Mithila. Ram is in Kishkindha. In a crisis, do I look for help back home or do I tap local resources? If I have to tap for help back home, I have to get the armies from Ayodhya and Mithila to march down to Kishkindha. An army moves on its stomach, food for everybody, resource management. They have to familiarize themselves with the local conditions, training and development for all these people, accommodation for all these people. Baba, as a visionary leader, manage crisis. He said, let me use local resources. Kishkindha is a forest land. He said, let me use the help of Vanaras. See, to call the Vanaras monkey is not right. Okay, monkeys take objection to that. Vanara is not a monkey. Vanara is somebody who is neither a man nor a woman, nor a monkey, animal. Some species in between. Okay. Many of us are some behave like Vanaras at times. Like when the war comes, we will know. Okay. Then somebody comes to distribute something, you know. Like they said, free tokens for 2000 rupees. Everybody and his uncle will become a Vanara. Whatever period, age, gender, income, you will all stand in queue for 2000. Vanara. Vanara means this is not working, only this is working. So he took the help of the local people. They were quick in climbing trees. They knew the way around all these small things. And when they had to catch that fellow, dacoit Veerappan, they didn't call the army from Punjab. They took the help of the local fellow there. They knew how to run around all these street corners. So they take the help of the Vanaras who know the local conditions well. Okay, there was an air dispute. See, another beautiful story of brothers. One set of brothers, Ayodhya. Another set of brothers come to Kishkindha. One brother, very strong fellow called Bali. And the younger brother is somebody, you know, somebody who is pushed around kind of thing. Unfortunately, Bali got into a fracas and they did not know whether he was alive or dead. And they crowned Sugriva king. Bali turned. Sugriva said, brother, welcome. He said, what brother? You locked me inside. You took me for dead. And he kicked Sugriva out. So when Sugriva met Rama and told the story, Rama said, I will help you. No further thought. Pran jaye par vachan na jaye. I'll help you. What was the common ground? So when in crisis, please look for people with common problems. Okay, help will come readily. That's why, you know, these days, you know, when you have people suffering from terminal illness, there is a support group of terminal illness. People with some kind of children having disabilities, support group of children with disabilities. It's a support group. So he looks for a support group. What's a support group? Ram's wife was abducted. Sugriva's wife was also abducted. Only difference was Sugriva knew where his wife was, Ram did not know where his wife was. So common cause, you have sympathetic vibration. These fellows will sync well together. And he knows Sugriva, so always go for a common cause. So he went for a common cause, killed Vali. We need an exclusive episode, Vali Vadam is a separate episode. We'll not go into that. He gave his word. Perhaps he may be wrong. He says, you know, perhaps I may have violated something. But you're a vanara, not a human being. So human values don't apply for us. And you have done a Mahapatakam. Mahapatakam is abducting another man's wife. When you abduct another man's wife, capital sentence. Capital punishment. I have punished you. You abducted your brother's wife. Oh my God. That is capital O, capital. So this is a value we all have to learn. One important value. Never covet anything that belongs to the other person. Whether it be property, whether it be iPhone, whether it's another man's wife, I would as spouse. Okay, it's not just the husband cannot covet another man's wife, but the wife, she can covet anybody else. No, it's a spouse. The spouse is not allowed. When the spouse coveted, when Surpanaka coveted Rama, another woman's spouse, she suffered. The story says that the nose was cut. Nose was cut only in the subsequent edited versions. Actually, when she threatened to move towards Sita, Lakshman pulled his sword out to stop her. Just to stop her. He didn't hit her. He's a Kshatriya. He wouldn't hurt a woman. He put the sword forward. And she hit her breasts against the sword and lost one of the breasts. So she was called the Bimba. She became a Bimba. And the cutting off of a woman's breast is humiliating. She went to her brother for that. And that value runs in India's blood for a very, very, even now it runs. You know, coming back to the times of Alauddin Khilji. Khilji was as a clear out, hesitated because there was a woman in front. And Khilji stabbed. This is history. This is Indian history. The Indian army goes into other border areas to defend. There are no instances of rape. In fact, there's a beautiful story which I told another place. There was an Indian soldier in a local, in one of those skirmishes, border skirmishes. The Pakistani injured man dying called the Indian soldier. He said, unzip my tunic. There is a picture there. They are my wife and daughter. There is an address behind. Please post it and write there that I died with a bullet on my chest and not on my back. Then the Indian Sardar said, hey, why should I send? Why didn't you ask your fellows to send? He said, arre chodiye sab, sab kayar hai. Aap jaisa bahadur koi nahi hai. The enemy calls me Bahadur. Remember, that is India. That comes from Rama. That comes from the legion of Rama. We should be proud of this Purusha. Rama is something that stands for glory of India. It's not just a temple. The glory of India is the Uttama Purusha. So this is how he promised. Came down. And they are building a bridge to cross over to Lanka. She has been found. I'm not going so much details into the stories. After Rama explores a few more characters as well. They are going to build a bridge to cross and cross over to Lanka. Hanuman was a known strong man. Ram did not call upon Hanuman to throw the first stone. He called upon two of guys called Nala and Neela. Why Nala and Neela? They had special ability to make stones float. The story goes like this, that they had the ability to make stones float. As a leader, as senior citizens in our own families, can we identify among our grandchildren people with special abilities? The contribution we can make to the, I'm going beyond son and daughter, I'm going to grandchildren, because that's, they are the ones who need support. See, in India, what happens once upon a time, we lived in joint families. Therefore, we had no need for counselors and therapists. Now, joint family is gone. But need therefore, so many therapists and counselors, you have to pay 1,000 and 1,500 per hour. So we identified Nala and Neela. And there was a squirrel, you know. There's a squirrel. The squirrel helped in building the bridge. How did the squirrel do it? The squirrel used to, you know, put its body, roll in the mud. The mud will come onto itself. Then it will go between the rocks and do the binding work. And in recognition of the squirrel's work, Ram patted the squirrel on its back. Those three strokes are left. So in a crisis management, if somebody helps you in crisis, if somebody helps you in times of need, please appreciate the person openly and leave a lasting impression for a lifetime, for a generation. Leave a mark like that. That's a squirrel, three things. Mark. Wonderful thing. Now they have crossed over. They have crossed over and some people say voice is breaking. I don't know, maybe, you know, there is one more computer being used. Maybe that's the reason. I don't know. My daughter is doing an office
there working. There is internet issue from your
side. I'm okay. Okay. No? From my side, once. Because my connection is showing stable. Occasionally, it shows it's unstable. Maybe there's one more computer being used. That's the reason. Okay. Fine. So, now they've crossed over. Somebody has to go as an emissary. Okay. He is called the emissary. Duta. He has to go to the Rama court and say, look, we have come for this purpose. If you fulfill this purpose, we will go away without fight. Who will you send for this? Okay, normally we will say send best man. Okay, opening Virat Kohli ko bhejo. One down, Virat Kohli ko bhejo. Last man, Virat Kohli. No wonder one Virat Kohli scores a duck means everybody goes. Change. He says no. There Nala Neela in one place, Anila. Anila means squirrel. And Hanuman to jump over the ocean as a sea. Now he identifies a fellow called Angada. Angada is the son of Vali. Vali and Ramayana and this fellow Ravana are two best friends. And to Ravana he sends Angada. Look at the confidence he reposes on that young warrior. So Angada goes to Vali, to Ravana, and says, I am Vali Putra Angada. Ravan says, do you know I and your father were friends? And this fellow called Ram killed your father? And you are coming to fight for that fellow? Are you not ashamed? You should listen to Angad's dialogue. If you can look into Tulsidas Ramayana, you should read that. It's written in that bhasha. He says, Ravan, you remember once as a child, when I was in the cradle, you tried to show your smartness to my father. My father caught you by his tail, brought you and tied you in my cradle, and said, look at the 10-headed insect. Ram killed that Vali. Understand that. And you are talking about you and I friendship. So better surrender. Then Vali says, and Angad says, do something. Look at the confidence. Angad says, I will put my foot firmly on the floor. If any one of your courtiers can move my floor, we will all go back. You keep Sita. And look at the confidence of that young Turk. Nobody is able to move the foot. Ravan tries to move the foot. He said, wait, Ravan. If instead of falling at my feet, if you go and fall at Rama's feet, are zindagi bach jayegi, yaar. Kingdom bach jayegi. Bacho, yaar. Dimag. Das haat, das sar hai tumhare. You have 10 heads, but you don't have brain even to hold in one head. Sar hai, dimag nahi hai. He said, sar rakke kya karoge? It is something for you and me. Labels, we have got, you know, lot of labels on our head. It's sorry to mention, you know, these days I don't use the expression retired officer of Reserve Bank of India. I don't need the label called Reserve Bank. Reserve Bank is brick and mortar, stone. I gave it existence. We are all hanging to label, retired GM Reserve Bank. That's only for pension sake. And sometimes you come looking for me in my area, they may recognize. I should be known as I am. Why do I need labels? If at all I should be known as son of a land in which Rama was born. Not some brick and mortar building. That is Angada's strength. You know, Ram Dhuta. Not Vali's son, Rama Dhuta. And he says, if you fall at the feet of Rama, a lot more uddhar ho jayegi. Okay, now let's go to beautiful character there. I always do this when I hear of this character. And that character is called Sita Maiya. Janaki, Vaidehi, Maitri. Newly married, comes to her husband's house, from a royal household to another royal household. On coming and getting married, her husband loses every bit of his property. What does the wife say? I have gone round 7 steps with you. Death do us apart. I will be with you. Cut our social media scene. My husband beats me. Put it in social media. My husband drinks. This is supposed to be put in social media. Instagram. I am in a toxic marriage. You are supposed to put it in. Somebody put it. I say, why don't you go and seek counseling? She tells me, what's your problem? I said, it's not my problem, it's my culture's problem. What happens in the house, it doesn't even leave my doorstep. And you're putting in a social media where everybody and his uncle is going to laugh at you. This is Sita. And then she came outside the firewall and was abducted by Ravan. Neither Ram nor Lakshman found fault with her. Nobody said, why did she violate the firewall? She said she is a very intelligent person. Something must have happened which must have questioned her dharma. That's why she violated the firewall. She is not someone who would ordinarily disobey her husband. But if she has come out of the firewall, there must have been some question of dharma there. She is a dharma patni of Rama. She is not somebody who is just grains are spilled outside. Something has happened. They did not find fault with Sita. So the Ram who did not find fault with Sita on day one could not have found fault with on Agni Pariksha day or on the Gobi comment. That's a different thing altogether. We'll come to that. So Sita. She is in, unfortunately in cinemas, you know, all these crybaby characters played Sita. We should have somebody strong play Sita. So Sita, Ravan comes. She picks up a blade of grass. She says, if you crossed this blade of grass, bhasma ho jaoge, you will be turned to ashes. The fellow was terrified. He didn't dare cross that. Look at her confidence. In crisis, if the man can occasionally be shaky, Ram was shaky at one point of time. He said, hey, Sita, where have you gone? He started to talking to the plants and deers and squirrels. He said, hey, Sita, where have you gone? In a crisis, if the man is shaky, remember, the woman should be able to convert the blade of grass into fire. That is crisis management. Ram hilega nahi, hum usse jyada atal hain. I won't be shaken. That is Sita. Ravan says, Sita, do you realize I love you? She says, oh, really so? If you love me, send me back to the person I love. You know I love Ram. Send him back to him. So if you really love me. And look at her wisdom. Look at the women of the house should have wisdom. Man, resilience, you know, capacity to bonds. Women should give him the wisdom to withstand the pressure. Sita was like that. Sita did another great role which is not publicized anywhere. When the war was going on, Sita managed the kitchen of Ravana's army. And she started cooking. This is my creation. Okay. It's not even, don't look for it in Rama. She started cooking amazing pulaos and good naan and things. And all the soldiers were thinking about coming back and eating and not fighting. So she weakened them by the kitchen. So even if you are in enemy territory, if you use this 6 inches of space here, we can do a lot of strategic crisis management. All of us, without exception in life, will face challenges. And any challenge is not easy to face, especially as we are growing older, there's a physical challenge. I am not as strong as I used to be physically. My eyesight is not as strong as it used to be. My hearing is not as clear, but are my values as strong? If that is so, the man, the elderly man and his woman together can manage great amount of crisis which the younger generation is facing today. They have a lot of wealth. The wealth that the children are earning today, I could not earn in my lifetime. They are earning in 1 year now. They have a lot of wealth. But do they know how to live? Standard of living is good. What about a standard of life? Ram, Sita, these are the two people who are going to chat about standard of life, of people, values. There's another beautiful episode. Vibhishana. Again, you know, one set of brothers, Ram, Bharat, Lakshman, Vali, Sugriva. Let's look at the third set of brothers. Ravana, Kumbhakarna, Vibhishana. Three brothers. Brother number one, Ravana. You can see that prototype all over the country today. Okay. Lots of labels. 10 heads. No brain. Whatever good things you have, I want. There are a lot of people like this in our families also. Grandfather's property, I alone will take. What about you? I will not. Greed for a property. Greed for all these gizmos. 10 heads. Whatever another fellow has, I must have. That is Ravana. See, Lanka did not belong to him. It belonged to his older brother. He coveted that. Mandodari was the daughter of another king. He coveted Bharata. He saw Sita, Bharata. Anything other person must have, I must have. You have a red balloon, I want that red balloon. You want a yellow balloon, he wants a yellow balloon. 10 heads. But even such a fellow had a loyal brother called Kumbhakarna. And look at the dialogue that Kumbhakarna says to Ravana. Kumbhakarna says, if you had allowed me to sleep for 3 more months, I would have been invincible. Why did you wake me up? He said, oh, Rama has come to invade. Why has he come to invade? Ravan could not look Kumbhakarna in the all 10 heads could not look into his 2 eyes. 20 eyes could not look into 2 eyes. Yeah, put his head down and say, I carried away his wife. He says, you carry away another man's wife and you want me to fight your wife. But that movie, you know, there's an action in that Kodumasar. But he says, I will fight because you are my brother. I would lay down my life for you. But one thing is that I will die, I'm sure. Because in a dharma yuddha, it has never ever happened that adharma has won. So 50% of me have already killed by asking me to fight for a wrong cause. I'm dead, but I'll still fight. I would prefer to die in Rama's hands rather than in your hands. Because if I didn't fight, you as the king of this land can give orders to execute me. And you will do it, I know. A fellow who has no values and carried off another man's wife will keep the cause. Then one day Sita tells Rama, look at how they weakened him. She says, if you had fought Rama, defeated him and told me, come with me, Sita, I would have come. You come at a time when Rama is out and you tricked him out of this place. So you know your 50% battle lost. You have to trick me. You cannot win a war. She psychologically finished him. Then he tells Meghna, go and fight. Meghna says, Papa, hua kya? Hum kyun lade? How can you face your son? Hey, imagine, you know, an elderly person like me. Will you go and tell your son and grandchildren I'm in love with another woman? This person could not face it. He says, Papa, if Sita had come on her own, if you had defeated Rama, I would have given my life. But you carry her away and you want me to fight. And Mandodari tells him, are you not ashamed? This is Ravan's side. Look at Rama's side. How he is protecting his army. He says, all of you are fighting for my cause, okay? Not your cause. So I will lead, arrow, all of you behind me. So in any issue which affects you directly, always take the lead. If it's a pension issue, you take the lead. Don't tell the grandchildren, you go and fight. Let's go fight. If it is property issue, your property, you take the lead. Okay, I had written in my bio data and I wanted to tell you, I have donated all my organs, okay? Every bit of my organs from my eyes downward is donated. And this is a decision I take. And I told my family, please respect that. Like that, you know, there are decisions for which you should be responsible. You should take responsibility. Arrowhead formation. Then everybody falls behind. Unlike Ravan, my problem, but you people fight. Then Sita comes. Ram did not ask Sita to go through Agni Pariksha. Sita said, I would like to go through. Quite simply because I am the queen of this land. Whatever example I set, others will follow. So if you are arriving from Mumbai to Tamil Nadu, don't wait for the authorities to put you through negative positive test. You say, I would like to take a test. Here is my certificate. COVID positive, negative. That's what she said. Who knows what virus I am carrying? I was with so many Rakshasis dancing around me. One 10-headed virus was dancing around me. What kind of exposure I got? Who knows? Why should I take this exposure to my country? And some people, you know, made a nice movie joined by people, you know, who are pseudo-feminists. They made him walk through fire. There is a text which nobody objects to. So everybody under his uncle is jumping on the text. She decided that in Ayodhya, Ram says, go away. Ram never said, go away. Ram said, this is what people are speaking. She said, I'll go away. Because as Raja Ram, he has responsibilities. As Sita Ram, he doesn't think of anybody else other than me. So if situation so demands, I will live away. Where is the problem? How many of you people are there, young people who are now put in so many years of life when you were in transferable jobs? Did not our wives live alone with the children? Did you abandon them? Did you ask them to go away? She said, for the exigencies of the situation, I am going to stay away. They say that some women said, see, Ram has abandoned you. She says, Ram has not abandoned me. And please understand, this is Ram Rajya. Even a mosquito is safe here. I have not been abandoned by anybody. That's called for the strength of will of a lady called Sita. A powerful character. Every character in Ramayana stands for great amount of commitment. Commitment to the word, commitment to values, commitment to vision. Whether Ravan. Ravan is, oh my God, such a glorious character. Glorious character in as much as so much of scholarship he had. He knew the Samaveda. He was a Veena player. His association was with Lord Shiva. He had such high contacts. But when it came to the moment of reckoning, when you fall from grace, can Ravana go and tell Shiva, I have carried away Sita, come and fight you for me? So when we fall from grace, then this value, there is something called a line called value. If this value goes away, there's something beautiful, you know, I like among the Vaishnavites. I put this nama, that means value standing straight. Some people put the values like this. They say value is my base. Some people put it like this. They say value is my depth. That's why we put it here and here. That's why we never come without anything on our forehead. If this is our value, if this is the kind of commitment I have in life, what will crisis do to me? What we face in life is challenges. Some situation will come which will make us have to take an action. When you take an action, there will be outcomes. Okay? If the outcomes are comfortable, we are all very happy. If the outcome is troublesome, ayo prarabdha. When you cannot face the outcome which is unpleasant, we call it a crisis. Or whatever you do, the solution is not in your favor, you call it a crisis. People's incomes are coming down. Family incomes are coming down. People are getting affected. It calls for an action. It calls for an action. It calls for prudence. It calls for frugality. It calls for charity. It calls for supporting the Rajya in power. Not weakening the Rajya. This is how crisis is managed. Rama is full of all this. When somebody is doing wrong, we have to point out, hey, you're doing wrong. Not saying that, hey, what if Rama rules or Ravana rules? Then you will be like that only. 10 heads with no brain. We have to. As there is a very beautiful verse in the Bhagavad Gita. This I will slowly conclude. We can open up questions. In the Bhagavad Gita, there is a verse which I will close. He says, Yadadacharati Sreshtaha Tattat Eva Itaro Jana Saha Yat Pramanam Kurute Lokaha Tas Anvartate Yat Yat Acharati Sreshtaha. Sreshta means the Sreshta Purusha, the grown up adult in the society. Forget the society, in our houses. We are supposed to be grown up adults. Yad yad acharati sreshtaha, the way we conduct ourselves. Tat tat eva itaro janaha, we will be inspired about what we do or not do. Tat tat eva itaro janaha. Saha yad pramanam kurute, whatever he sets as standards. Lokaha tat anuvartate, people will follow that. Beautiful Kabir Das quote. Jako rake saiya mar sake na koi bal na baka kar sake jag chahe bari hoy. So if you stand for strong values, mar nobody yaar koi hila nahi sakta aapko. Bal na baka kar sake jag sahib. They are very high values. We need not 100% stick to these values. But if these values are meant to be there for us to be guided, if the values are there and if we can be guided by these values, there will be a quantum transformation in our lives. Our life moves through P, E, R, M, and A. P is basic pleasure. E is engaging pleasure. Chai masti pleasure. R is relationship pleasure. From chai masti, we become closer friends. Okay, relationship pleasure. M is meaning. Hey, we do drama, we do competition, we sing together. Meaning pleasure. Out of that comes awareness. Parma. A, awareness pleasure. Then I realize my potential as a human being. Many of us in this position as elderly people in the society have done well. We have brought up our children well. Now the only way to guide the children is in a unique kind of way. Not doing blah, 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 blah. Vichar is there. Prachar. Close. The problem is many of us do prachar. No vichar, prachar. In our time, you know, tomato was available for 5 paise. You did not have 5 paise to buy tomato. Then prachar. Who wants to talk about your life? You know, we all studied under streetlight. Somebody studied under streetlight for one day. They say he studied entire life under streetlight. Nobody wants prachar. Nobody can hear your vichar. But they can see your achar. Achar means not a pickle. Don't consider achar into pickle. Don't make it a pickle. Acharam, conduct. They can see your behavior. Rama, Purushottama Rama, stands for acharam. Come what may, unshakable. If we as senior citizens can maintain dignity, poise, elegance, gentleness in our life, compassion, you have a lovely values. Get up in the morning and smile at people. Hi, child. How are you? Don't say grumpy. Where is my coffee? Where is my newspaper? What is there in the newspaper? 2,501 gone to COVID. What is there in the newspaper? What is the newspaper? Who touched my newspaper? Who touched this? Is this more valuable or the child more valuable? The child drops this into hot water. What will you do? Condemn the child and make the child feel permanently guilty for the rest of the life. This is a contraption. I can buy it for a few thousand rupees, but I can't buy the child's mind for hundreds of thousands of dollars in generations. There is a value. Yadadacharati sveshtam putitaila karoja. I'm much younger to a lot of people here. There are so many seniors here. I seek your blessings. This acharam should reach not just our country. It should reach the world. It's meant for the world. Jai Shri Ram. Jai Anna. I seek your blessings. There are questions, anything I'd gladly like to answer.
Thank you, Mohan sir. Thank you so much for the simple and wonderful narration. This was a very different narration I heard so far. Yes, members, if anybody has to have any questions, please raise your hands. We'll unmute you.
I'll go to gallery view so that I can see people's faces.
Yeah.
I would like to see the people, person who is asking me a question. Anybody can ask any question.
Yes, Nagaraj sir.
Ramayana beautifully explained through the Ramayana characters by Sri Krishna.
It's so nice and so touched. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Sir.
Yeah. I yes, Raji ma'am.
Yes, sir. What said and done? Rama is the our admirer or whatever lord, whoever it is. But that pushing Sita and Sita into the forest back. But I don't know some meaning for that.
it is quite simple. Okay, I will tell you a beautiful meaning for that. It's again a story which I read somewhere. They say one day Sita was pregnant and Kaushalya was combing Sita's hair. And Sita was narrating, "Oh, you Ashoka Vanal, oh, Ravana used to come with 10 heads, big mustache, sword in hand. He used to do Bharatanatyam like Rudra Pandavam." Rama said, "Oh my God, if she continues this thought for the next 7 months, my son will be born like Ravana. Send her away without explanation. She will think and say, oh my God, who will give socks to Ravana? Who will give cornflakes to Rama? Who will give a handkerchief to Rama? That stupid fellow cannot even match his trousers and pant." You know, when the wife is pregnant, she is sent away from the husband because she's constantly living in her husband's thought. The fetus will develop with the husband's glorious qualities. Purushottama Rama knew. They say Lava and Kusha looked like Rama and behaved like Rama. And one more beautiful explanation, he didn't send her to a forest. It was not our corporate jungle living in old Mahabalipuram Road. It was Rama Rajya. Even mosquitoes were safe there. She went into Vasishta Ashram. What Vasishta was a fellow, as a teenager, he protected Rama, who gave education. So when I am going away on a long tour, I prefer to send my wife to my teacher, who I know will take better care of her than even my parents. So please, let's not go into that local political episode. He sent her there. Even if he sent, he did it proper. I don't question my Rama. He's standing in depth of foundation. My father gave me a slap when I was young. Do I question him? Yeah, I'm marching. That one slap turned me, you know, turned me away from smoking for the rest of my life. It happens, you know, how many of us? My father used to give me one look. At the age of 50, I used to be scared of my father. I was afraid to drink water in beer bottle. Father is saying, what is that? Papa, water, pa. That's it. Rama is a glorious Purusha, Uttama Purusha. Purusha Uttama. He can't do wrong. Okay. That is my strong opinion.
Hello.
Sir.
Anybody? Yeah. Who's next? Yeah. Sumitra. Sir. Sorry, I always remember Jayalakshmi.
Yes, Sumitra. Yes, sir. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, anybody? Yeah. Yeah.
Sir, in this value system, how do we explain Kaikeyi's conduct? She is creating a crisis for the whole family, and then she is not punished in any way.
Kaikeyi created crisis. Now, what is the punishment a mother can get?
No, she didn't behave as a mother.
Yeah, she didn't behave as a mother. She behaved as Bharata's mother. Okay. Bharata came and told her, if you use Tamil, Neelaura Amma. And Bharata said, nobody will ever name his daughter Kaikeyi. Tell me, any person who would like to name your daughter Kaikeyi, is that not punishment enough?
Yes.
There is Sumitras in the family. There are Kaushalyas in the family. Will you name your daughter Kaikeyi? Ayyo, Kaikeyi. The son told her, you are a mother. Ayyo. You sent Rama away. What kind? You didn't understand your son. That is punishment enough. I don't have to be punished and watch her be screwed in public. I don't want that. The son cursing is enough.
Yes, very good.
Thank you, Ramesh. Yes, Nagaraj, sir, please go ahead, sir.
The father can't take the curse of the son.
Hello. You are given a very nice lecture.
Yeah.
And we would like to hear more of your lecture. So if you give some links for that, you'd find.
I will send you all my YouTube talks.
Okay,
I've got regular Bhagavad Gita lectures, about 30-40 talks are there.
Yeah.
I will give you all of that.
Okay, thank you very much.
One more thing, sir, I would request, please don't call any of my thing a lecture, because I don't lecture.
Okay, then what should I call it?
Simple, thought sharing.
Okay, fine.
Offering on the fleet of Rama.
Okay.
I am talking about the glory of that verse, Purushottam. It is my worship to Rama.
Okay, that's fine.
It is my worship to the Vedic culture.
Mr. Mohan Krishnan, how do you, what to put for to get, say, watch your videos?
Okay, I will send you the link. I will send the link to Felicita. She will pass it on to all of you.
Okay,
sir.
Thank you.
Okay.
Sir, yes,
Rajapan,
sir.
Yes, Jashri Madam Bolia.
Right. Yeah, sir, I like your example that joint family gives the counseling.
Oh, yeah.
Really, really good.
Anna. See, yes. Then I had problems. We used to go to our Chacha Ji, Tao Ji, Mama Ji. Ab kahan hai sab?
Nahi hai, sir.
Nahi hai na. There used to be one character called Phupa. Ab Phupa ko dhoondne museum jana padega. Phupa hai hi nahi. Arre jab bua hogi tabhi na hogi Phupa. Sab single family ho gaye.
Right, sir.
So I do.
Good. I liked it. Everything I like.
Thank you, Jayashi. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes, Jay Lakshmi.
Mohan, there's no questions actually, but I really liked your talk and everybody enjoyed your talk. It was very nice hearing you, and we would all like to hear more talks from you in different subjects.
Sure.
Mohan, can you give me 1 minute?
Sure, Rajapan. Sure. Rajapan, sir, yes.
The way you have given, Raman's family brothers, Sugrivan family brothers,
correct.
Ravana family brothers.
Huh.
It was such a good comparison. And the behavior of the brothers nicely developed and presented. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes, Vasant Subramaniam, ma'am, please go ahead, ma'am.
There are others.
Vasant Subramaniam, ma'am, please unmute me. Ma'am,
unmute me. Amrita, she'll speak. The moment is Amrita, she'll speak.
Okay, yeah, Amrita.
Okay. So I'll call you Ravi.
Oh, yeah.
A very contrasting picture you presented today from what the play we did. Everything is very nice. I really enjoyed it. The only one question I'm asking. Rama asking Sita to go in the fire. Is it justified?
Okay. Rama did not ask.
It is not depicting that lack of confidence in Sita.
He did not ask her to take a fertility test. Please understand that. He did not ask her to take a fertility test. Agni Parisha here stands for going through some appropriate screening. Suppose somebody landed from Bombay to Chennai today, I would say stay 14-day quarantine and come inside. Where is your mask? Where is your gloves? Where is your sanitizer?
No, that is meant for public.
Is meant for Sita also.
Isn't it going against Nari Shakti?
I saw
a dance performance.
He had told Sita, 1 minute.
Sita is asking.
He had so much confidence in Nari Shakti, he knows that fire will not do anything to her. And the story goes that when Sita came out, fire came and begged Rama, "You burnt me, not Sita." So this dance performance, anybody will do anything, you know. They made one drama in which they say Padmini is in love with Alauddin Khilji. What a rot. And whole of India protested. That is artistic license. We should allow. One fellow will come and say, "I want to make a movie in which Sita is singing duet with 10-headed Rama, Ravana. Kamala Hassan will play all the 10 heads and they will dance." Telephone, Manipul, he will say that is dance. That is what media is doing.
Aadha cup se bhi kam coffee bana degi strong.
Maybe coffee chahiye.
Yeah.
So, okay. please let us not go by social media. Let us not go by paid press, which is programmed to destroy Vedic culture. They want you to be ashamed of Rama.
Yeah, but he did not believe in Sita, right?
No. He believed in Sita. He knew fire will not do anything to her.
No, that is true, but he believed in that Dhovi who told him.
He's
sad about Rama, right?
See, let's say I am the prime minister of this country and somebody talks against my family. I'll say, yeah, inquiry commission bitha do. That's okay. All he did. एंड ही सेड इंक्वायरी कमीशन बिठा दो. ही सेड एक काम करो, मुझे इंक्वायरी कमीशन नहीं चाहिए, आपको सीता नहीं चाहिए, आई शी विल लिव सेफली इन अ फॉरेस्ट जब तक आप लोग लेसन नहीं. सी वन मोर थिंग, रामा इज अ पुरुष उत्तम धर्म. हम धर्म पालन करने के लिए अपनी फैमिली की सैक्रिफाइस करेंगे. आई विल सैक्रिफाइस माय पर्सनल फैमिली लाइफ फॉर द सेक ऑफ माय किंगडम. सीता हैप्पीली वेंट अवे. वो आप निरूपा राय को देख के मत जज कीजिए कि सीता वॉज क्राइंग. वो ड्रामा में दिखाना पड़ेगा ना, अरे राम तुमने मुझे भेज दिया, क्या गलती की, ऑल द ड्रामा हैव टू डू. शी सेड राजा राम कैन सेंड मी अवे, सीता राम से मैं कभी दूर नहीं हो सकती. सी व्हाट हैपेंस इज, सी छोड़िए पब्लिक को, छोड़िए सिनेमा को, प्लीज हैव कॉन्फिडेंस इन अवर ओन रामा, अवर ओन रामायण. द प्रॉब्लम इज हमने छोड़ दिया रामायण को, एंड द वेस्टर्नर्स आर हैविंग फन. It is like, you know, somebody comes and says, India is a dirty place. You'll say, ha, you have not seen. Come, I will show you even dirtier corners. Okay. Whereas you go and tell somebody that, dekho, you try. Japan mein jaake boliye ki, I found a piece of dust in the road. The entire nation will keen the dust and say, kaha hai dust? Here, we are waiting for others to point out. Dekho, tumhara Raman mein problem hai. Raman mein problem hai. You are happy, no? So, Ram, my problem. Somebody comes and tells my mother is faulty, and I will say, yes, yes, my mother is faulty. Hum uncompromising Ram ke baare mein kuch ulti baat sunenge nahi. Hum log kitne liberal hai na, aap Ram ko gaali do, Sita ko gaali do, meri amma ko gaali do, meri Vedic culture ko gaali do, hum bolenge aap great ho. This is our problem. Hum log weak ho gaye. We have to look at the fellow and say, kya bola aapne? गलती से किसी तमिलियन ने नॉर्थ में बोल दिया तमिल तेरी माँ, वो बिगड़ गया. अरे मेरी माँ तमिल नहीं है, मेरी माँ पंजाबन है. छोटी छोटी, अरे तू मेरी माँ को तमिल बोलता है, वो पंजाबन है यार. तो वैसा है कि हमें, यू नो, अगर किसी ने हमारे वेद, हमारे हमारे भगवद गीता, हमारे ब्रह्म सूत्र, हमारे वैदिक कल्चर की तरफ आंख भी, वो आप गाना याद रखिए, देयर वाज अ मूवी कॉल्ड हकीकत. इसमें दे मेड अ मूवी हकीकत, उसमें एक लास्ट सॉन्ग है, कर चले हम फिजा जानो तन साथियों, उसमें लास्ट में लाइन है एक, ओके, इतना याद रखिए, खींच दो अपने खून से जमीन पर लकीर, इस तरफ आने पाए न रावण कोई, तोड़ दो हाथ अगर हाथ उठने लगे, चूमे पाए न सीता कदामन कोई, राम भी तुम ही लक्ष्मण साथियों. ऐसे गाने हम अपने बच्चों को सिखाना चाहिए. अरे सीता की तरफ आंख उठाओ तो तुम्हारे आंख फोड़ देंगे, राम के बारे में बात करो तो जिह्वा काट देंगे. वी शुड बिकम मिलिटेंट. वाहे गुरु तलवार निकालो, राम के बारे में बात करो तो हम छोड़ेंगे इनको, दुम्स कर देंगे. हम लोग गाली दिया था, हाँ हाँ निकल, हाँ हाँ बाली कायर है, इसके पीछे भी बाली को मार. वी आर सप्लाइंग मेटीरियल, रामा वीक है. Let us defend. I will not agree.
All these values, we are listening today and then going tomorrow. Okay? We are serious citizens.
you listen to these values and practice them now.
No, correct. But how to transmit it to our children and grandchildren?
Stories. Make them listen to stories. I will conduct a storytelling workshop for all our senior citizens. Please tell stories to your family.
Yes, sir. Please.
Okay, please tell. I have only one appeal to make. Each one of you donate money to Dignity Foundation. Humko kuch nahi chahiye. Let each one of us donate 1,000 rupees to Dignity Foundation. Kali workshop kar denge.
Okay, we will.
I will train each one of you to do stories of Ramayana, Mahabharata, कबीर दास, दोहे, देन अवर अकबर, अपना बीरबल के. आई विल टेल यू हंड्रेड्स ऑफ, आई विल गिव यू 100 स्टोरीज टू बी टोल्ड इन फैमिलीज. लेट अस मेक, dignity foundation ko strong banaye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Next, we'll move on to Rekha D. Rekha, please go ahead.
Yeah. Yes, Rekha. Rekha saw my drama as well.
Jai Shri Ram.
Jai Shri Ram.
Very, very energetic, sir. I was very like, it goosebumps up to me because like I could see the depth. I could see the patriotism. I could see your lot of things, which I really love it. Sir is stuck, or I am stuck.
Yeah, that's not. I think there's a little. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir. Yeah. Sir, as the values, no, we need to remember, recall it through these stories or by going through the Ramayana Mahabharata again and again. That is what I was thinking.
Yes.
And already two questions were similar to that. So my question is that only that how do we imbibe all these qualities, values in our next generation?
We need to
practice of listening or doing something has to happen so that it gets imbibed into them. When they are doing something wrong, they have to recall some character and say that this is how I need to be. They can have one character as to mentor themselves, as keep them as role model to their life.
I'll share with you a small psychological trick. When the children ask you questions, don't ever tell them you lack Shraddha. They are very intelligent. They are questioning. They are influenced by the Western media. First, tell them your question is valid. Can we look for answers together? Can you assure me that you are open enough to look at a proper answer? They will come to our side. हम लोग स्टार्ट करते हैं नो यू हैव नो श्रद्धा दे विल से एज इट इज घर में ही एनिमी बैठा है व्हाई शुड आई गो आउटसाइड सो माय चिल्ड्रन आल्सो आस्क मी क्वेश्चंस इन फैक्ट दे आस्क मी मोर क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज़ दे से यू टॉक टू पब्लिक बहुत भाई लोग तुम्हारी ताली बजाते हैं हम बताते हैं आ जाओ घर में हमारी मैक्सिमम घर में बजाते हैं लोग माय चिल्ड्रन आर्ग्यू विद मी आई टेल देम Your questions are valid. Your thought process is valid. अरे आखिर तुम हमारे बच्चे हो ना मेरे thought ऐसा है 50 years ago तो तुम्हारा आज का इससे ऊंचा होगा. I would love to answer your questions. I would like to answer your friends' questions. सबको लेके आओ. एक दिन सत्संग बुलाइए घर में. Call for a Zoom. Talk करते हैं. We will have a talk. And at the end of the talk, 30 में 28 को convert करके वापस भेज देंगे.
Nice.
You have to have that. See, kan kan mein Ram. So like Kabir Das, main Ram ko dekhne chala. Okay. Phir kuch din baad kya hua? Ram, main nazar nahi aa. Jit teku tit tu, bis Ram hi nazar aa raha hai. Kabir kho gaya.
You mentioned about the joint family system.
Yeah.
Had the advantage of tolerance.
Yeah.
And now the present day generation, they don't have tolerance at all. So how to get back the tolerance into
who did they learn intolerance from?
Pardon?
Who did they learn intolerance from? Please understand, children don't listen to you, but they copy you.
Yeah, that's correct. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
In the past, suppose your coffee had half a spoon sugar less.
Can you shout?
What did you tell your wife? Didn't your mother tell you how to make coffee? Did you ever tell your wife? कोई बात नहीं यार कॉफी में शक्कर डालो या नमक डालो तुम्हारे लिए हम कुछ भी खाएंगे. Suppose we had told my wife, see, it doesn't matter. तुम जहर भी डाल के दो हम पिएंगे. Then the child will learn. Oh my God, what a father, यार. But a little bit of salt, you start abusing the wife's grandmother onwards. None of you know how to make rasam. So see, first, very important, as dignitarians, as people in our 60 plus, respect our spouse like Rama respected Sita.
Yes.
And that is where the foundation of the family starts.
But sir, they don't stay with us. Young generation don't stay with us.
Let them stay physically far away. It is like a kite. दैट उसका मजा है उड़ने में, लेकिन डोरी आपके हाथ में है. Okay, always remember the fun. How would you like a child sitting at home doing cycle repair shop outside your house? You love your son to be, you know, chairman of Google, chairman of this. Google will not become in Chennai and Pune ke bhai wo Kut Road mein nahi aayega Chennai mein. Google means he has to go to America. But the dori, you know, that resham ki dori should be in your hand. One tug, the child should come back. Emotionally, he should be with you.
They are not.
We should build. They will be provided. We have to learn to love them unconditionally. Ab hum log kya ho gaya na? We are like an ATM machine. Card dalo, number dalo, password dalo, niklega. We have to tell them, are tum pyar karo ya na karo, I love. My blessing is there. May you always be abundant. Let's start this. Close your eyes, think of your family and tell them, may there be abundance. May there be lots of happiness. May there be lots of good health. Tum dur raho, lekin khush raho. See, there are, once I think I told this story, I don't know, in this forum. We bring up children in various ways. One is like a cat. Cat, na, till the eyes are open, the cat takes care of the kitten. The other is like a monkey. The monkey tells the baby, "Are mujhe pakdo, I will keep jumping all over the place." The third is like a fish. Lay the egg and watch it from here. The fourth is like a tortoise. Eggs are laid in Bay of Bengal. The tortoise goes away and lives in Iceland. Yeah. Man hi man mein, the control is there. See, the bond of affection, the bond of love, respect should come through our Ramayana, our Vedic culture, our heritage. I don't want Father's Day greeting. Forget him for 364 days. On the 365th day, Swiggy aake cake dega. What? I don't want all these greetings. If the morning he thinks of me before doing something wrong, he says, "Nahi yaar, my father doesn't approve of this. My father doesn't approve of this language. My father doesn't approve of money made this way. My father says it's not important how much you make; it's important how you make. My father says it doesn't matter what you do; it matters how you do." उसके लिए ना वी शुड बी क्या ज्ञान सागर है. दिस प्लेस शुड बी यू नो ओवरफ्लोइंग विद नॉलेज. पर प्रॉब्लम इज दिस प्लेस इज नॉट ओवरफ्लोइंग विद नॉलेज. दिस प्लेस इज ओवरफ्लोइंग विद कंप्लेंट्स. तुमने हमें पूछा नहीं. यू हैव नॉट रिप्लेस्ड माय कंप्यूटर. यू हैव नॉट गॉट मी गिज़्मो. यू हैव नॉट गॉट मी दिस. अरे सेंट अभी तक नहीं खरीद करके दिया. अभी तक मुझे एक बॉटल विस्की खरीद करके नहीं दिया. वी शुड बी लाइक यू नो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स एंड नॉट कंज्यूमर्स. करके देखिए. आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू लेक्चर. करके देखिए. मेक अ स्मॉल चेंज, वन इंच हियर, एंड Prabaha will come from that side. Because these days the grandchildren, the next generation, which is under 35, needs inspiration. When we all acted on our dignity theater and acted, you know how much response came from the youngsters? They said, they all clapped and said, "Are kitna masti hai, you're enjoying life." They want us to enjoy life. And then we are not enjoying life. Okay, we are worried about all this. Because there are two types of creases, you know. There are one type of crease which is called worry lines. There is another type of lines here. These are called laugh lines. Let us have lot of laugh lines. Let my face become wrinkled, earned, not worry lines. Every morning 6:30 I run a meditation. Anybody who wants can join that. I will remove all your worry lines. I'll make you all smile. That's not enough. We don't even know how long we'll live. We don't even know whether I'll be giving another talk. Okay, grains of sands are running out. We have to live so gloriously that the children are inspired to live well. India has a population of 130 crore. 65% is under 35. Look at the blessing we can give them. Through Ramayana. Next, whenever next convenient, I'll do stories from Mahabharata. I will tell you Kabir Das ke dohe, wonderful we'll have. We'll all sing together Kabir Das dohe. I will tell you stories with Kabir Das dohe. We can have a lot of fun. There are certain simple habits we can introduce. Every morning, 15 minutes of meditation. 15 minutes of loud prayer. Loud prayer, not silent prayer. Loud prayer. There is a song I sing every morning. 15 minutes. Loud prayer. Okay. Then habits like, you know, writing down your journal. Not complaining, daughter-in-law did this, mother-in-law did this, what did this thing. All small thing happened. Somebody picked up, somebody called you, greeted you, somebody did something for you. Small things. Chote, 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 chijo mena, let's find ananda. The small drops will become a big sagar. I call myself happiness coach because of this. I want infection hona chahiye. All of us should be infected by happiness. That's the kind of joy we should be able to exude. Let us make a vow that we will try. Koshish karte hain. Let us try. What is wrong in trying? Achha hi to hai. Anybody? There's a hand I saw. Whoever wants to speak. Yes. Anybody? Anybody wants to speak? Some hand?
Okay, thank you. I think everybody have done with their questions. Thank you, Mohanji. Thank you so much. I request Kasi sir.
1 minute. Madam.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Yes, please.
So Mohanji, very well explained the mantra for the younger generation as well as the older generation also. Achara, vichara, prachara. What a beautiful thing you have explained. You know, whatever is there in, you know, we have every person has head but no brain. And every person knows what to do, but how to do, we don't know. How to bring it into prachara also was not at all known. Those mantra you have taught us in a very well, beautifully you have explained. And even for the younger generation also, you could teach all these things. And all. And one the sentence which inspired me was, in our days, what you said, you know, in our days, we never need any counselors. But the present day people, present day younger generation need counselors for everything.
See,
the real thing what you have told was really applicable to every younger generation. For every small, even minute things, they need counselors, they need physicians, they need some experts, they need Google. Yeah. But in our days, it was not at all there. In our house, only everything was available.
Yes.
So that is what we were getting the lessons. That is what the big advantage of joint family.
Yes.
Very well explained, sir. Very well. We need such talks again and again. Thank you so much.
All these counselors are born because of the software boom.
See, my grandmother also had a huge, great software. She used to make hand murku, you know.
Yeah.
Perfect three lines, no out of shape. What software? It was only here, no?
Yeah.
And while making that, she used to counsel. Multitasking she was doing.
Yes.
Used to make nice sweets and we never, for Diwali, I don't remember buying anything outside. These days, we buy only outside. So, the beauty is that Vedic culture. First of all, we have to rename ourselves. We are not Indians first. So, these kind of, you know, so much of Vedic culture doesn't mean books. Vedic culture means something which is valued for all times to come. Simplicity, awareness, bhaichara, good achara, good vichara, maintaining physical discipline. See, I mentioned about three. To do something wrong, I should be ashamed. See, once upon a... Yeah, police.
Sir, will those days come back again?
I don't know. We can make it. Ram Raja, we can bring it back. After Kali Yuga, Satya Yuga has to come. Why wait that long? Do it today, no?
Yeah.
Start making Satyadyuka in my house, our house. Who stops you?
Yeah, correct.
Krishna says, if you want to create Satyayuga, even I cannot stop you. If you want to do Kali Yuga, even I cannot stop you from doing that. Like Duryodhana. Duryodhana says, I know what is wrong, but I can't stop from doing. I know what is right. I can't stop from go to do the right thing. We need to bring Krishna into our lives. We bring to need Ishvara into our life. We need to bring Rama into our lives. That doesn't mean religion. That means conduct. Achara. Vichara. Vichara. Achara. Prachara. V-A-B. PAT. This has to be in line. Listen to lots of stories. You organize regular. I will tell you 10 stories one day in which you can laugh a lot and think a lot.
I think our topmost leader is following whatever you have told, Rama.
As of now, I don't know.
No, correct, you know. There is nation is first.
Yeah.
Rest,
yeah.
All the rest next.
Yeah, correct. That is how it is.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yes, Tasi, sir, please go ahead with your vote of thanks.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. I'm delighted to have this opportunity of Thanksgiving. First, I will start with Jayadas for introducing Mohan in such a nice fashion. Then, of course, I have seen a lot of postings in the chat giving a lot of feedback. I'm sure Mohan also would have seen it, or he may see it later. But the way that interaction between the members and Mohan was something wonderful today, which is, I have not seen other programs. And a lot of faces which I have come to know recently, like Nagaraj from Bangalore, Jayalakshmi from Bangalore, Lalitha Iyer from Bangalore, or Ramani Iyer from Vashi, Shiva Rudrappa, all these faces, when they are coming to the program, which is conducted by Chennai chapter, I am very much delighted. And I saw Anil from Indore, my recent friend, he has also attended. It was very good program. And Mohan, of course, nobody need to say anything more than the members themselves have expressed how with humor he has brought about. Everybody knows Ramayana, everybody knows Mahabharata, but the way that he has selected the crisis management topic and giving a relevant to the issues or the characters from Ramayana was wonderful, and everybody enjoyed. So I don't have to add anything new to that. Isn't it, Mohan? Everybody has expressed themselves the way on the chat, number of them, and also while talking to him during the interaction. And Mohan's depth of knowledge and the wide subjects he was taking from the movies, songs and all that, singing and telling those relevance to the subject, was something extraordinary. Thank you very much, Mohan, on behalf of Chennai chapter. And I thank each one of you for having attended this more than 1.5 hours, and he kept us tied down.
let us do some Zoom action. We all learned, you know.
Yes. That's very correct.
From your heart.
Thank you very much.
Wonderful. Bye.